Welcome to Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video we make a feed screw for the cutter grinder fixture. This is the feed screw. It involves some knurling, using a die to cutter thread and some turning between centres. So let's go into the workshop, see how we make it. So I'm going to use this off cut to make a new feed screw for the grinding fixture. So this is about 55 millimetres long. I've just put the small off cut in the chuck, 3-jaw chuck. This one's self-centering 3-jaw chuck where I can adjust it to get it to run true. I'll put my dial indicator on. The other end of the bar has already been centred, so what I want to do is get this running as true as possible, face it off and centre it. You can see there's a 5-thou run out, that's 5-thou at the bottom. Each division is a 1/10 of a thou. So what I want to do is get the lowest reading, then adjust the screw here. Half the error. Should be about there. You'll see that's gone down to 1.5 thous. So I'll bring it to the lowest reading again. You can see now the screw is further round, so it probably needs some adjustment on this, but I'll take it down a little bit more with this screw. Reset it to 0. See how that's running. So it's less than 1 thou. That's the lowest reading. Take this, halve the error. It's about 4/10. Turn the outside down so I know the outside will be running true to this center, and then when I need to do the other side I'll put it between centers. Let's talk a little about knurling tools. This is a knurling tool. It has two rollers which have the knurl formed on them. It can pivot on a center pin, and the other part goes into your tool holder. This one is a fixed one, in other words, you can't alter the position of the knurl wheels. And the knurling tool doesn't cut a knurl, it crushes a knurl into the material. As I say, this is a coarse one, fixed wheels, make them bigger or smaller, they're fixed on that position, and it'll self-center to the bar that's been knurled. This knurling tool is another type. Once more it fits onto your tool post. And this one's got two arms. These are adjusted by this nut on the top, hand nut. As you tighten the nut on this, the two knurling wheels come in closer. Then you feed it into your bar. And these two wheels crush the knurl. As you can see, there's a difference between the two. The small one here is a fine knurl. You can get different knurling wheels to give you either a rougher or a finer knurl, depending on what you need. This one has quite a rough knurl. I need to be able to use it as a hand screw to turn it by hand. So I'll use this one. This one you set the same, set it on center line, bring the workpiece into the middle, and then adjust these and it crushes the knurl into the bar. With this one, set it on center line and feed it in, and that crushes the knurl into the bar. This one puts more pressure on your cross slide than this one. You can change the wheels in these knurling tools just by taking the pin out and putting another wheel in, and you can buy sets of knurling wheels with different finishes and even different shapes. Let's set this up in a tool post and see what type of knurl we get. So I've just set it up. I'll go over what I've done.
As with the parting off tool, set the nail square. Well, here I'm just putting a square on the chuck and bringing the tool post square so that each wheel is parallel to the part being nailed. On this one I've set the tool height so that the centre of the wheels is centre to the bar. I've just done that by eye. Also, before I've started, what I've done is got a small wire brush and just brushed the knurling rollers. This gives you a nice clean set of rollers so you're not crushing bits of swarf into your part. Just bring the knurling rollers in, move it up and down the bar, but I just want to knurl on the end, so I'm just going slightly over the chamfer I put on. It will crush the surface and it'll probably end up going into the chamfer, so I'll go slightly over the chamfer. This is just going to be for a hand screw to tighten up. So I'll put some oil on that I use for lubricate. It's actually engine oil. Start the machine up and wind in the cross slide. You'll see there I'm starting to get the knurl form. Just want to wire brush these rollers, get the bits out that have come off the, and then give it a final run so it's got a clean set of knurls. I'll move it to the edge on this one now, it's got a, and then just bring it in so it's about an eighth of an inch over. Start running, let it pick up. As I'm feeding it in, it's picking up the position. Move it across slowly, feed it in, leave it there till it stops making a noise, till it's finished, and then you can see you get a reasonable knurl on the finish. It's just run over slightly into the chamfer, it's not cut too deep, so put a chamfer on there. Before I remove the chuck, I always put a board on the bed just in case I drop the chuck or the chuck key falls out. I don't damage the slideways or the V-ways. So I just turn the chuck around until it locks, put the key in, just tap it, and it should unscrew. I use a tusk brush just to wipe the thread so then now there's no swarf in the thread. On both the drive plate and the headstock. Also take out any bits that have gone down the centre of the bore. Centre in. This is a large revolving centre, number 2 Morse taper piece. This is the driving dog or the carrier. It goes onto the end. Because I don't want to damage the knurl, I'm just putting a small piece of sheet steel between that and the bolt. I'll just tighten this up, put it that way, bring the centre in. Now this pin's sticking out too far because I might not notice that. Bring the tool across and hit the pin. So what I want to do is undo the nut and wind the pin in so it's clear of the outside. So that will now go between centres and it just catches the edge and turns it round, pushes it round. So I know there's nothing protruding outside this. need to go about 34mm. Slightly over, I'll leave it at that. I've put my tool on the right hand side of the tool post this time, turned it round in the tool holder. That's so I can now get in up against this centre. I've changed the centre from a big one to a small one, both still a rotating centre. And all the, and what I've checked as well is that when this comes round, it's not going to hit my tool post. This is the highest point. So I've got at least 5 or 6 millimetre clearance there, and I only need to go down 2 millimetres here. It's a smaller diameter. I've changed the carrier to a smaller one. I'll have to move this bar, the drive bar, in. So all I need to do now is put the 6mm thread M6 on there. That's finished. Put my 3-jaw chuck back in. This time I'm gripping the part on the internal chuck jaws. I've put my horse taper guide bar in for the die stock, and I've put my mandrel in the headstock so I can turn the chuck from the back of the headstock by hand. Cut in a 6mm thread. Now that's locked up against the face. I can take this out. This is the finished part. This part is what I made before for the cutter grinder, and it had a thread in and fitted on the end of a cap head. This time I've reamed that out to 8mm, that's all I've done, take the thread out of it, so that this will fit on here. Instead of having a cap head and Allen key, you can adjust it with the end there. So let's go and fit it on the fixture, see how it works. Before, this was a cap head going through the centre, so now I can do it just by holding the thread and turning. Also, it feeds in, so when I want to index it, I undo the indexing pin, hold this feed screw, rotate this round to the next hole that I need, put the indexing pin back in, and I know that the feed screw hasn't adjusted, because what was happening before, as I indexed, you see that this barrel was turning round, and it was turning the, because it was fixed to a cap head, it was putting the feed on as I turned.
That's another job done. That's it for today. Hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.